Okay guys, welcome back to another video on the LightCanon construction. So we've made some progress since the last build log, but here I have a fan. This is going to be the main cooling for this flashlight. So there's going to be a big heatsink inside of this, and it's going to get cooled by this 80 millimeter fan, which I put on the end cap over here. So it's very simple. I'm going to pull it out so you guys can see. Basically the 80 millimeter fan here. I've got the corners cut off so that it fits inside this piece of tubing. And then on the edges, I've stuck some foam cut into the shape of a circle. And on this side, I stuck on some of that black velvet paper to absorb light, and that's really just for looks. There's no need to use that here, but I didn't really like what it looked like with the fan and then the foam, so I just stuck that on like a sticker, and now it looks much better. So this fits perfectly inside of here like that, and that's what the end of the flashlight is going to look like. So this is a 5 volt fan meant to be used with USB, not a 12 volt fan, because the battery we're going to be using in this flashlight is only going to be a 3.7 volt LiPo, so we need this fan to work with low voltage. And I'm going to get some batteries here just to show you guys. So we're going to use two 1.5 volt batteries just to demonstrate this. It works with 3 volts, so when we have the battery, which is going to be closer to 4, it should also work perfectly fine. So let's see, I'm going to hold this here. Whoops, the cables are just hanging around. There we go. Not very loud. It will probably be louder when we have the more powerful battery inside. But yeah, it makes enough airflow. That's going to cool the heatsink and the LED. So very nice. But that finished. But we still need to have a way for the air to get out of this tube. Air comes in the back. There is no space in the front for the air to come out, since right behind this cover I made, we have the lens and the lens focusing assembly. So this is not going to have anywhere for air to leave, so we need to make some vents, and those are going to go on the side over here. So I've measured how far this piece moves back, the one that holds the lens. It goes almost all the way to this line, so made this line over here. We're going to have a square vent on this side and a square vent on this side. And we're going to cover that with some of this PVC mesh. This is actually supposed to be the fan filter for the power supply on my S340 computer case. And it's not much of a filter, but we are going to use it as a grill so that stuff doesn't fall into the flashlight and damage the bare LED. So those are going to go on either side like this and allow air to flow out the front of the flashlight. So it's going to go through the bottom, through the electronics, which are going to be here, through the heatsink, through the LED and reflector, and then out the side. So it's going to cool pretty much everything except for the lens, which doesn't really need any cooling. And yeah, so to do that, I have my ingeniously invented cutting heated knife made with a blade and a soldering pen, and we're going to use this to cut through the PVC tube, make some nice clean cuts for the vents. So that's what I'm going to do right now, and I'll see you guys when I have that done. Thank you. Alright, there we go. We got the two rectangular holes cut out very nicely with the sharp heated cutting thing I made. And there we go. So, one on each side, symmetrical. And we have this mesh that we're going to just easily just stick on here like that. And we should have some awesome airflow right through our flashlight. So, I'm going to use some tire glue for my RC car to glue this, since it dries within seconds and it's also transparent so you can't see it. We're just going to glue this around the edges right there, and that will end off this episode. So I'll stick this on and be right back. So there we go, we got it finished, got it glued on, glue is all dry, you can barely see it, it's very transparent, and it's very strong as well, so this is not coming off anytime soon. You can see it looks a lot better now with the hole covered up like that with the mesh on both sides. I think it looks pretty cool, and I did test it with the fan. We've got very good airflow through both sides, and that's going to provide very good cooling. So, yeah, that's about it. Some vents here, and the fan in the back. All we need to do to finish off the cooling part is put the heatsink in, and I've got that ordered, so it should be here in about less than a month or so. So, actually, by the time you see this video, probably just a couple weeks, or a couple days even. Who knows? So, yeah, that's gonna be for another part of this build series. And that's about it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.